Benita, so excited you're here. Alexis, my queens, and Galaxy J3 Star. Let's see who that is. They're connecting to audio. I think we're just waiting for like one or two more. For some of us, it's your first time, and I'm so excited that we're growing. So this will be a flow, an intuitive flow. It's a different type of yoga because it's a Thursday night group who works really in a boot camp all week long. So it's more gentle than anything else. We do a flow with a middle intensity for a little bit. So I love to guide you here on Zoom. It's a bit different. So I really encourage everybody to listen to their bodies and take the time to be mindful about how your body feels during each pose. And if there's any pain you're feeling at all, just please get out of the pose and find the space that's right for you. And for this yoga today, it's going to be about your breath. The breath is always the most important pose. So I ask that everyone be very mindful of your breath and completely let go of the past and the future and just be here during this class. And if you get distracted with thoughts of the past or the future, just come back to your breath. Is that cool with everybody? Awesome. Any injuries, anything that I should know about that anyone has had recently? No, we're all pretty good, healthy. There's a little kitty with us and beneath this screen. This is so exciting. I love animal yoga. All right. So as of right now, the waiting room is quiet. So we'll just hop right into it. I do use a blanket for my practice. If you have anything nearby that will help you, either a blanket or a pillow, you can prop your hips up on it. And that just helps us with more comfortability. And I think that the more comfortable you are, the more happier you are. So let's get nice and comfortable wherever you are, on a nice comfortable seated position. Sitting straight up, spine nice and erected. Sticking in the belly so it's not straight out, nice and tall, chest expanded, it's open, hands resting on your knees, palm facing up towards the sky. Tuck your jaw in, the chin just a little bit, relax your jaw, soften the muscles on your forehead, close your eyes, begin to relax the mind, release your thoughts. Turn your awareness into your body versus away. Bring it in. Observe your breath as it comes in and expands your body. And exhale as your body contracts, the shoulders fall further away from your ears, softening your fingers, softening your wrists. Allow the muscles on your face to completely relax. Take a moment to scan your body from the top of your head, down the back of your eyes, down your nose, your throat and shoulders, softening the shoulder blades further with every exhale. Softening your heart, all the muscles in your chest. Scan your arms from your elbows down to your wrists, all the way to your fingers. Scanning the chest, the core, your hips, down your hips into your legs, into your knees, all around your knees, the front and the back of your knees, down your legs, into your ankles, out from your toes. With this full body scan, Become aware of any areas that might feel tighter than the others. If there's any blockages that we can witness. And if there is, bring your attention to that specific space. Allow your next inhale to go directly into it. So if it's your neck or your shoulders or your belly, just bring your breath in a little bit deeper this time, inhaling through your nose, expanding that specific space, stretching and loosening up the tension, and then exhale, release that tension out from your mouth. Inhaling through your nose, your next breath into that space, whether it be your heart, your neck, maybe even your head. Expand it with your inhale. Bring your focus, bring your attention, and then exhale, release, let it go. One more of those. Big breath in through your nose, slowly expanding your body. Exhale, gently, slowly release that out from your mouth until there's no air left in the body. Gently bring your breath in. And now bring an intention with your breath into your heart. And allow this intention to be where you want the energy of this class to go. You're here for a reason. What is the intention for this class? To release pain or control. Maybe it's peace and love. Whatever it may be, allow that intention to stick with you through class. Send your energy from this class to this intention. And at the end of the class, we'll release it. Together, let's bring our hands together in the center of our chest, palms together. Thumbs touching your chest. Take this moment to feel your breath on your inhale. Your chest rises against your hands. Exhale together. We do an Interlace your fingers, push your arms, extend them out, fingers facing you, palms facing away from you. You can open your eyes or gently gaze at your screen. Push forward and extend your arms up above your head, arms back the size of the ears. Push that chest forward. Exhale, bringing the arms down, roll the spine, chin to your chest, gaze down. Again, push forward and up towards the sky. Arms back, chest forward, and release. Exhale, bring the belly button in, roll the spine, chin to your chest. One more, pushing forward and then up, reaching up, extending back. Exhale, roll the spine down, vertebrae by vertebrae, hands down, chin to your chest. Now bringing the hands, keep them engaged, but bring them to the back of your head, closing your elbows, gently applying light pressure to the back of your head, releasing all that tension from your neck. Exhale from the mouth, relax your jaw, soften the forehead. Keep exhaling nice deep breaths all the way out. Inhale, keeping your arms in the back of your head, opening up the elbows, gaze up towards the sky, chest open. Exhale, roll the neck back down, close your elbows. One more, inhaling up. Exhaling, close those elbows,
And bring the chin to the chest. Exhale all the way out. One more. Inhaling up, shoulders back. Gaze up towards the sky. Push those shoulders really back. And exhale, release back down. Elbows closed, chin to your chest. Now release the hands. Bring the hands back to your knees. Bring your neck back up to center. Bring the ear, the right ear over the right shoulder. And we're going to roll our neck back as we inhale. And exhale, allow the chin to fall forward. And bring your full awareness to your neck. Letting go on that exhale. And do this a few times. Close your eyes and just imagine your breath all around your thyroid, all the glands in your neck, all the muscles. One more. Keep your neck down on your chest and switch direction. Bring the left ear over the right, left shoulder. Right. Exhale down. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Releasing all the weight from the week, all the thoughts that might come into your head, all the pressure of the world, just let it roll right off your shoulders, off your neck, let it go. Give yourself love and peace during this time. Roll the neck back down and then back up to center. Now bring the chin over your left shoulder. And then again over your right shoulder. And just go side to side at your own pace, breathing in on one side, exhaling on the other. Inhaling on one side, exhaling on the other. And this feels like no, right? Sometimes it's harder to say no. No is a powerful word. So whatever each individual heart has to say no to, just say no. Getting that full stretch, gazing over your shoulder. Two more. And slowly return back to center. Back of the head goes straight back. Stretch your throat, stick out your tongue, go Close the jaw, exhale into your chest. So now we're saying yes with the throat chakra extension. So inhale back, exhale, close the jaw, down, all the way out. Two more, inhaling back. It sounds silly, but it's so powerful. Close, exhale down, let it all go. One more, make this one count, inhale back. Exhale down all the way up and gently rise back up to center, shoulders up towards your ears. Inhale, exhale, roll the shoulders back and down and create a nice flow. Shoulder blades up, inhale, shoulders down, exhale, inhale up. Exhale down. Beautiful. Two more of these. Really bring it up. Squeeze at the top. Exhale. Inhale up. Exhale. Roll those shoulder blades down. All the way down. Good. Now relax the shoulders. Let's bring our arms up. So extend the arms out to the sides of the body. Palms facing up. Feel all the energy around the body. Stretch those arms up, 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 reaching up, and place the right hand on your left knee. Hold the outside of your left knee. Reach with the left arm up and then roll that arm back close to the body. Place your hand down, either your fingertips or the palms of your hands, and twist. Look up and over your left shoulder. Take a deep breath. Exhale, twist a little bit more. And just breathe into this pose, twisting the organs in the belly. So breathe into your belly. Bring your breath all the way into your body. Let it go past your chest. Expand and grow. That's all we have to do. Breathe. Inhale. Exhale, slowly release. Come back to center. Arms extended out, chest open, reach up towards the sky, left hand on the outside of your right knee, right arm back, place the fingers or the palm of your hand on the mat and twist up and over the right shoulder. Taking a deep breath in, exhale all the way out. Inhale in through your nose, exhale out through your mouth. Twist a little further if you can, challenge yourself just a little bit. Inhale, exhale, slowly release, come back to center. Beautiful. Now we did our neck and our shoulders. We're going to head down to our hips. With our hips, we're going to lean to the right side, bring it back, then push over to the left. Forward and just make this full circular movement and exhale as you go forward, inhale as you go back. And now you can be as deep or as soft as you will like. This is your practice, your body. It's a beautiful body, so take care of it. Give it some love. If you find a sweet spot, go ahead and savor that moment. Take two more, just observing your neck, your shoulders, your elbows, your knees. Make sure you're breathing. Take one more. Pause in the front. Take this nice deep stretch where you're extending the torso forward, chest nice and open, and then switch directions. You can close your eyes. Again, just breathing in as you go back, out as you go forward. You can go as fast or as slow as you want. And just add some flow to it. It's almost like a dance. Just groove with your body. Find your own flow. And do this for two more really good circles. Beautiful. And on the last one, we're gonna meet in the front again. You're gonna extend your arms out. And both arms, walk your fingertips as far as they will go until they find resistance. And when you find that resistance, just go ahead and melt your elbows, melt your neck, melt your shoulders until you get to your forehead, if you can. If you have a nearby pillow or a blanket, you can place it underneath your forehead. But wherever you are is exactly where you're supposed to be. So just release the shoulders, release the elbows, softening the fingers, and just relax for a moment. Getting that nice deep stretch from your hips all the way down. Beautiful work. Take a big exhale out, melting your heart down. Just softening, releasing with your mind, releasing with your body. Inhale, relax, exhale, release. Gently gaze forward. Keep the palms of your hands extended onto the mat.
and walk your arms back one by one. Bring your shoulder blades all the way back. We're gonna do an inversion, which means go the opposite way. So bring the shoulder blades back. You're gonna place your hands as extended like stars on your mat behind you. Push your chest forward. Keep your hips on the earth, knees nice and flat. Pushing from your hands gently, lift your hips off of the mat. Allow your neck to stay nice and relaxed. Don't exaggerate the neck, but allow your arms to support your upper body. You can engage your glutes and push your hips forward on your knees. Breathe. Deep breath for three deep breaths. All the way to your belly, expand, exhale, release, push forward maybe a little bit more. Squeeze those glutes, open those hips, ladies. Exhale, release, slowly bring it down. Good job, gaze forward. The leg that's in front is now gonna go to the back. So we're gonna switch legs, open up those legs, shake them if you need to. And let it all out and switch. Go ahead, put that other leg in front and place the opposite one. So you're going to feel a bit of a difference. Again, keeping the arms very strong, pushing from the palms of your hands up into your shoulders, chest open, gently lift your hips off the mat, keeping your knees nice and firm, softening the jaw. Keeping those hips as forward as possible. Engage your glutes, breathing into your belly. Expand, push forward on your exhale. Two more breaths in through your nose, out from your mouth, in through your nose, out from your mouth. Gently exhale, bring those hips down, walk those hands forward, and we're coming to a tabletop position. How's everyone doing?
This is awesome.
Okay. In your tabletop position, you want to be in alignment. So the wrists below the elbows below the shoulders, hands nice and stretched out, very strong hands, tailbones up towards the sky. There's two ways you can do this. You can do this with your feet on the mat or softened, whatever's comfortable for you. Good job. Perfect. Cat and cow. Inhale, gaze forward. This is cow. Exhale into cat, bringing the shoulder blades up, bring the tailbone in, chin to your chest. Squeeze at the top. Exhale, release, drop your belly, stick the tailbone up, gaze forward, up towards the sky if you can. And then again, go ahead, rounding the spine, vertebrae by vertebrae, bringing it all the way in, squeeze, chin to your chest, tailbone in, all the way, shoulders up, inhale, exhale, go ahead and release, bringing the belly down, bring the tailbone up, gaze forward or up towards the sky, emphasize that tailbone to really get that stretch. For that lower back, one more of these. Go ahead, bring it all the way in, squeezing at the top. Inhale, all the way, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Exhale, go ahead, drop it. Exhale, all the way out, gaze forward. Good job. Keeping the left hand on your mat, inhale, right arm up towards the sky. Thread the needle, bring the right hand all the way through the center of the body until the right shoulder is on your mat. Extend the right hand all the way through. You want to relax those right fingers, relax the wrist.
extend your left arm out in front of you, fingers on your mat. Breathe into it. Now is a good time to just release, open up that shoulder blade. If the left hand is comfortable where it is and you want to go a little bit deeper, lift the left arm up towards the sky, extend it, reaching with your fingertips up. You can keep it here or go one step further, bending your left elbow, bringing your left fingertips to the inside of the right hip, twisting that left shoulder back, gazing up and over your shoulder blade. Deep stretch, breathe into it for three. Slow, deep breaths in. Exhale out. Every exhale, you let go and open. Two more. Last one, make it count. Beautiful work. Inhale, left arm up. Place it down on your mat. Strong palm. Push from the left palm up, bringing the right arm all the way through. Lift that arm up. Exhale, back to all fours. Good. Switch sides now. So we're going to keep the right hand down. Inhale, left arm up towards the sky. All the way, reach as if someone's pulling your hand up, and then go ahead, bring it all the way through the center of the body until the left shoulder is on your mat. Release here, bring the right arm forward. Nice long stretch from your fingers all the way down to your hips. Deep breath all the way in. Exhale all the way out. Inhale, arm up if you wish. This is one modification. Second one, go ahead and twist at your elbow, bringing the right hand to the inside of your opposite hip. And reach, bring that elbow back, shoulder open, gaze up towards the sky over your shoulder. Release and relax as you breathe into this pose. Two more deep breaths. Inhale, right arm up, extend it fully straight. Release, bring it down on your mat. Strong hand pushes up from your right arm, left arm, release it and bring it back into a tabletop position. Good job. Now we're going to bring our hips onto our heels for mini child's pose, but we're going to bring it over to the left, up into a cobra, out into the right. So it's this full body stretch. You're bringing it back to the right, forward into a cobra, really pushing those hips forward in your cobra, and then again around the town. So this is a beautiful position. Close your eyes. Inhale as you go back. If you want to kind of rock in your child's pose, that's good. You want to stay in your cobra for a minute, that's okay too. This is your practice. You take your time and just move it from your head all the way down to your feet. Good job. Beautiful work, everyone. Okay, that looks good. Just release it. Release the knees, the hips, your shoulder blades. Yes, so good, Patrice. Woo, feel that energy moving around. No more stuck, stagnant energy. Now bring the hips to the heels. release for just a moment in your child's pose. Allow the hips to go as close to your heels if you need to open up your knees a little bit. Good. Relax your fingers, your wrists, your knees, all the way your shoulders. Soften your tongue, the jaw, the muscles on your forehead. And just breathe, inhaling through your nose, exhaling from your mouth. Inhaling through your nose. Exhale from your mouth, let it go. There's so much happening in the world. That's not what we have to carry. We have to let it all go. Now is the time to release and relax and make space for everything that's coming your way. So much is coming. We have to make space for it. Now just gently with your neck, just inhale and gaze forward. From here, you're gonna walk your hands out to the right side of the body. Staying in your child's pose, and then just relax your knees. Relax your head on top of your knees, over your knees. Your chest should melt down closer and closer to your body with every exhale. Long stretch from your fingers to your hips. Good. Now gaze forward. From here, we're going to walk our hands all the way over to the left side of the body until it wouldn't go any further, and then melting your chest over your legs. Release and relax into the side angle child's pose.
Beautiful.
Inhale, gaze forward. Walk the hands back into center. Come into the opposite way. We're going to bring the hips in the left direction. Now up and over, back, and sway into it. And push forward as you exhale out into your cobra. Inhale, just back. And again, let this be a flow. Let this be a dance of your body. Bringing those hips forward, really extending it. Moving that divine feminine energy. Good work, Patrice. Just let it go. Around two more times. Rock those knees. And come back into your tabletop position. Activate your toes. We're going to go into our first downward facing dog now that we're nice and warmed up. From here, same exact tabletop position. You're going to gaze down between your hands. Gently lift your knees off your mat. Exhale, straighten your legs, extending the back of your knees, melting your heels onto your mat. Pushing with your hands, push the mat away from you, stretching, bringing those shoulder blades back, hips up towards the sky. Melt your left heel into your mat and bend your right knee. Now switch, melt your right heel into the mat, bend your left knee, and walk the dog. Just inhale on one side, exhale on the other, stretching those toes, pushing back, melting the heart, gazing at the center of your mat or keeping your eyes closed. Good, just walk it. One breath in, one breath out. Good work, everyone. Now melt both heels down, all the way into your mat if they will. Come onto your tippy toes, gaze at the front of your mat, walk with the tippy toes to the front of your mat. Good job. I meet you in a forward fold. Inhale, halfway up, hands above your knees, straight back, tailbone up. Exhale, melt down all the way, bending your knees gently. Relax your head, allow the crown to face the earth. Relax and release. You can place the right hand on the left elbow, the left hand on the left elbow, and just sway from side to side. Gently swaying like water. Good work. Side to side. Keep exhaling. Nice deep breaths out. Inhaling through your nose, exhaling from your mouth. Release your hands from your elbows. Just gently let your fingers work that water side to side as you gently straighten into a standing position, rising slowly, slowly, slowly. The last piece is the elbows. Bring them all the way back. Interlace the fingers and the lower back. Push those hips forward. Release, exhale, straight standing pose, mountain pose. Release your fingers from your lower back. Extend them out to the sides of the body, all the way up to the top of your head. With your right hand, grab your left wrist and lean to the right side. Exhale all the way up. Pushing that left hip out, inhale to the center, switch, right hand grabs your other wrist and push those hips out. Be aware of your feet, nice stable foundation, pushing on one side, exhaling on the other, release, come back to center, exhale, those arms come down. Place the feet hip width apart, so give them some space. And we're gonna do our hips again, because I know we're always working on these hips, ladies. So place the feet hip width apart. We're gonna push our right hip out, bring it back, and over to the left. Forward and around the town. Inhaling as you go back, exhaling as you go forward. Good job. And just do your own speed, your own flow. Release all that lower back tension as you go forward. Good work. Take one more in this direction. Pause and then switch. Good. Push it forward and out. And this is so good for our digestive system. It looks kind of silly, but it's really good for us. We can do this every day, just moving all that energy out from our hips, down our legs. And the last one, just bring it forward to the back and down. Now we're gonna do a wide-legged forward fold. So feet really anchored onto our mats, leaning forward, straight back, shoulders down, melting the hands down again. Head, top of your crown is facing the earth. Place the left hand on your mat. If you need to bend your knees, that's okay. If not, please keep them straight. Inhale, right arm up towards the sky. Deep stretch, reach with those fingertips all the way from the right fingertips down to the left hand. Nice long stretch. Exhale, right hand down, switch. Push from the right hand up towards the left arm, extending a full stretch. Breathe into it. Exhale, both hands down. Yogi squat, place the toes facing away from you, ankles in. Bring the feet a little bit closer together. And you're going to bring your hips all the way through the center of your legs with your elbows. Push against your knees, straighten that spine, opening up your chest. Foot is completely melted onto the mat, the hips and the toes. Push through this. You're doing great. This is a yogi squat. Tuck your chin in just a bit. Gaze forward. Feel the belly as you inhale. Extend out to your legs and then release. Bring the belly in. Two more breaths. You got this. Inhale in through your nose. Extend the belly all the way up to your chest. Open that heart. Exhale, release. Last one. Inhale in. Exhale all the way out. Good job. Release the right arm. Bring it back to the body. The left hand. Bring those hips slowly and release the legs out in front of you. You can wiggle them out. Good job. Now we'll stretch our legs, making our way down. Awesome work. With your left leg, go ahead and stretch it. Open it up and bend your left knee, bringing the right foot into the left leg. Good job. And we're going to walk our left fingers out to our toes. Nice deep stretch. You can place your peace fingers around your big toe on your left foot, arm in. Inhale, right arm up, reaching for your feet, twisting, gazing up towards the sky. Inhale all the way in. Exhale all the way out. Inhale all the way in. You should feel it in your right hip. Do your best to keep your hip on your mat. It will want to rise, but bring it down with your breath. Inhale in, exhale down. Inhale, we're gonna twist. Bring your torso above your leg. Bring both feet, both hands to your feet. If the foot is too far for you, just grab onto your leg, whatever you can get onto. The most important part is that you can melt your shoulders, melt your chest, melt your body into your leg as close as it will go. And just take a moment here to fully relax and release, giving that left leg your positive energy. Inhale, gaze at your toes, walk your hands back, return to center. Switch legs, so extending the right leg all the way out and bending your left leg. Bring the left foot into the right leg. Nice straight torso, reach with your right hand over to your feet. Again, you can peace sign your big toe. Push that foot in as you inhale. The left arm up for a full extension from your hips all the way to your fingertips. Reaching. And just breathe into it. Wherever you are is where you're supposed to be. Be kind and gentle to your body. This is your temple. Breathe into it. Now gently twist your torso, bring the torso above the leg and melting the chest over your leg. All that energy from your heart. Give gratitude to your toes and to your knees. And just be gentle here. Soften your shoulders, soften your neck. All the muscles in your face. Mm-hmm. knees forward at your knee. Gently walk the hands back. Bring both feet in into a butterfly. Now you can grab your toes or the outside of your foot. But really what's important is to be on the flattest part of your spine, pushing the chest forward. Exhale, we're gonna melt over our butterfly. Give it a cocoon. So bring it down again, soften those shoulders, soften the neck, and just melt your body for a few breaths over your feet. And gently begin to rise. Slowly bring your knees in. Extend your legs out. One more forward fold and inversion to just melt your heart onto both legs, reaching them forward. Stretching from the base of your spine all the way up to your shoulders. Deep stretch, melting your heart down. Gently gaze forward and walk your hands back. Bring the shoulder blades up and we're gonna do our inversion, bringing the shoulder blades up. We're gonna go into a reverse plank, pressing the hands down into the earth, feet extended out in front of you for a nice long stretch. Now push from your fingertips, the palms of your hands, lifting your hips up off the ground. Reverse plank, lifting the body with your hands, keeping your heels on the mat. Toes can be facing straight up. Push from your hands. Maybe on your exhale, you gain some momentum. Push your hips even higher. Bringing those hips up. Keep your neck engaged. Soft neck, soft muscles in your jaw. Pushing from your hands. One more deep breath all the way in. Exhale and slowly release it. Good work. Bring those knees in. Give yourself a hug. Now we'll go into our boat pose. Come from the hug, extending the legs out. Gazing at your toes. You want to make sure that you're on your flat part of your spine so that way you're not on your lower back. Good. When you get here, engage your core, opening up your chest, chest open, knees bent, gaze at your toes. Now release your hands. Breathe into it. Take a nice deep breath in. Exhale out. Inhale, squeeze the knees in, give yourself another hug, bring your chin to your knees, maybe you kiss your knees. Our knees are so important. We want to have them for our entire lives. Now, one more boat pose. Go ahead, extend your legs out, release your hands, and now you can stay with your knees bent or go ahead, extend your legs out. Look at the space between your toes. Keep that core nice and strong. Allow it to shake if it will. And then slowly, slowly, slowly begin to bring your legs down, bringing the back slowly to your mat. You can stay in that 6-inch range and just challenge that core. That would be awesome. Let it burn for a moment and then just go ahead, release it. Bring the shoulder blades all the way to the mat. And relax for a moment here. We're almost in Shavasana, but we're gonna give ourselves a back massage first. So bend your knees into your chest. Wrap your arms around. Good. And rock side to side like windshield wipers. Just rolling that spine. Rock side to side. There should be no tension. So relax your shoulders if you need to. And just gently rock back and forth. And now from the windshield side to side, you're gonna create a circle. So now we go a little bit forward, back and down. In one direction. And when you're ready, switch directions, bringing it back in the opposite side. If you need to send your legs all the way out, that's okay. Full body. Keeping your arms on the mat if they need to balance you. And now extend your legs straight up towards the sky, toes facing towards you. Go ahead and roll your ankles. Roll your toes. Maybe even do it with your wrist. Release all that energy. And now bending your knees, bring them rounding the rib cage, bend your knees in into a happy baby. And just like a baby, you want to be happy here. So maybe you smile, you rock back and forth, grabbing the outside of your feet or the peace signs against your big toes, whatever's comfortable for you. Massaging your digestive system. Just breathing into this. Feel your belly expand on your inhale against your legs. And then release it. Maybe you kick out one leg, kick out another leg, just like a baby. We are actually born doing yoga, so we're just remembering. Releasing all that energy in our legs. Now release your hands from your feet. Bring your hands to the side of the body. Bring your feet into a butterfly. Again, bringing the soles of the feet together. Adjust your hips and shoulders if you need to. And with your left hand, place it on your heart. The right hand, place it on your belly. And take a moment here to just feel yourself breathe, allowing the muscles to relax into your mat. Let go of anything you may be holding on to, physically, emotionally, or mentally. Now is a good time to let it go and bring your attention to your breath. As you inhale, your right hand rises. And as you exhale, your left hand rises.
Beautiful.
Gently begin to bring your knees back together. Keep your right knee bent, extend your left leg out all the way. Extend your right arm out. Twist the right knee up and over your left leg, gazing up and over the right shoulder. Full body stretch. Melting the right shoulder into your mat. Slowly bring the right knee up. Bring it all the way in. Extend that left leg all the way out. And then switch. Bring the left knee in. Extend your right leg out. Toes pointing either up or towards you. Place the right hand on the outside of the left knee. Extend the left arm out to the side of the body. And twist the left knee up and over the right leg. Keeping the left shoulder on your mat, gaze up and over your left hand. And breathe right into those hips, right into that lower back area. Good. One more breath, inhale, and exhale, come back to center. Bring both feet to your mat, the soles of your feet on your mat, knees somewhat close together, but not touching. And we'll come into a bridge pose before our Shavasana. So keeping your shoulders on your mat, gently lift your hips up a few inches off the mat, reaching with your fingertips down to your heels. So bringing those heels as close as they will come. And now push up a little bit higher. Bring the shoulder blades together underneath you. Interlace your fingers. Push the hands down as your hips go up. Inhaling, deep breath into your belly, keeping the neck nice and relaxed. A lot of the weight is on your shoulders and on your feet. Push. Two more breaths. Inhaling in through your nose, out from your mouth. And slowly release arms out to the sides of the body. Exhale, hips down. Inhale, chin to your knees. Squeeze those legs. Give yourself a big, big hug. Be thankful that you showed up for today, that you made it this far. All the gratitude in the world. We're so thankful for you. Give yourself squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. And when you're ready, go ahead and exhale into your Shavasana, extending your left leg all the way to the left side of your mat, the right leg to the right side of your mat. Bring your hands to the sides of the body, palms facing up towards the sky. And just take this time to relax your entire body. Softening your toes, softening your ankles, soften your knees, all the muscles in your legs, all the muscles in your thighs. Just allow your legs to be so heavy onto your mat. Feel supported and protected. It's okay to relax. It's okay to release. Now is the time to let it all go. All the energy around your hips.
the bones. Relax your stomach, all the muscles in your core. Relax the lungs, the kidneys. Release any tension around your stomach. Relax your heart, your chest muscles soften. You feel your shoulders on your mat. Relaxing the back of your head, softening the arms from your elbows into your wrist, each and every finger, all the muscles in your fingers. Relax. Relax all the muscles in your neck and in your jaw, softening the muscles all around your mouth, especially your tongue. You can bring the tip of your tongue to the roof of your mouth if you need to. Relaxing the muscles around your eyes, your nose, the forehead, all the way up to your scalp. Now is your time to relax. Take a few minutes in your Shavasana, just breathing slowly and deeply as your mind fades away, the body fades away, and you're just left as the observer of this experience you're having. You're observing without judgment, without time and space, just being. Being is enough. Take a moment in your Shavasana.
I am not a day. Calm down. Calm down. Calm down. Eventually.
Begin to bring the awareness back to your physical body by taking a deep breath in through your nose, exhaling out from your mouth. Bring your awareness to your fingers and to your toes. Begin to move them. Wiggle all the fingers, wiggle the toes. Become aware of your outer extremities as you awaken from the Shavasana. Rotate your wrist, rotate your ankles in one direction. If you feel in your Shavasana you'd like to stay there, you can absolutely take your time and embrace this time. For you. If you're rotating your wrists, twist in the opposite direction, rotate those ankles in both directions. Now reach with your arms up and over your head as if you just woke up in the morning, keeping your back flat, arms. And now legs, reach with those legs, stretch those legs out as you stretch your arms back and release those arms. Go to the side of your body, the left side, and come into a fetal position using your arms as pillows or your hands, whatever's comfortable for you. Bending your knees in and going into that fetal position, the one we've known since we were in the womb. It's brought us comfort. So find comfort in that fetal position. Find comfort in this season of the life that you're in. Find comfort in this present moment. Is all we have. Just breathe into it. It's okay to relax. We're restoring at a cellular level. And now with one arm, place it down. Extend the leg that's on top, straight out, placing the inner foot down, and just gently walk your way back up with your eyes closed if possible in a lotus seated position. Returning back to where we started, the circle of life, the circle of yoga. Bring your hands down to your knees, palms facing up, relax your shoulders. And be aware of the body now, observing all the way through from your nose down to the base of your spine. Release out from the spine, all the way from our nose. In through the nose, into our bellies. And just take a moment to return to that intention from the beginning of class. And now is the time to give gratitude and thanks as we release it out, let it go. Into the power of nature. The organic flow has your back. The universe has your back. Whatever you're manifesting is manifesting for you. Feel that creative energy. Feel that love spiraling around your body. There's a beautiful light within you. You are ignited. You're bright. You're so beautiful. Now bring those palms together in the center of your body and begin to create a warmth. Create fire between those hands. When you feel it get warm, I want you to place your hands on a space on your body that you need it the most. And okay, so on our body, we're gonna place those hands either on your heart or on your mind, on your stomach, wherever you need love. Maybe it's your knees, maybe your lower back. And feel that sensation, feel the warmth of your hands healing your body, healing the heart, healing the mind. Whatever it is you need, now is the time. There's no better time than now. Let's bring the hands together in front of us. Let's lean forward as we bow in gratitude for one another, for sharing this safe space, and for those who I've been practicing yoga and sharing yoga. I'm so thankful. Namaste. Namaste. Thank you so much.
Thank you
for showing up today. How's everyone feeling? Hi, Jamie. Thumbs up. You're so beautiful. Everyone here is amazing. I'm so grateful for this group. And for our newcomers, how was it? Thumbs up, yes. My heart is so full. Thumbs up, Patrice. Hope you're feeling better and that the migraine and the cramps and everything goes away. Yeah.
Much better.
Good, I'm so glad. I think it's Joan maybe has the speaker on.
Now, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Okay. It's just echoing a little bit.
Very good class. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you. Good to see you. Have a good night.
You too. Good night.
Thank you.
Good night. Thank you.
Good night, everybody. Thank you so much. We'll see you next week, Thursday nights at 7:30.
For sure.
Take care.
Good night. Have a good week.
Thank you. Alexis, so much love. Where are you now?
Right now, I'm in Alabama.
Are you there with your family?
Well, my family is about an hour away from me, but I see them once a week, so it's really nice.
Oh, good. That's nice to be with them. I'm happy you're here.
It was relaxing.
It was relaxing. You enjoyed it? Good. That's the intention. It's a nice class, and have a cup of tea and take yourself to your own universe after this, hopefully.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, dancing helps with that too.
Yes, absolutely. Is that what you're doing?
Dancing? This? Probably. And setting up a little bit on yoga cues. Your cues were so beautiful and so precise, clear, love it.
That fills me up. I'm so grateful and thankful to hear that.
Thank you.
Working on it.
Yeah.
This is my thing. I'm so grateful.
Yeah, me too.
I hope to see you next week. This is the same link, okay?
Okay. Awesome. Okay. Yeah, I'll come back next week. Thank you for having me.
Yay, of course. It's so good to see you. Have a beautiful night, Alexis.
Yes, you too. Bye, Jasmine.
Soon. Okay. Ciao.